WinCC version 8 step-by-step, Visual Basic for applications for automated configuration in the graphics designer. In this section, I'm going to show you an example of how to use VBA in the graphics designer editor. We use VBA for automated configuration, so the example that we're going to create is every time an IO field is added to a screen, it'll automatically create a static text label with the text containing the name of the tag associated with the IO field on there, and it will copy some properties of the IO field into the static text label so that they look the same, and it will group them all together. So here's how it looks, and I've got the script on a screen. So if I just grab tags and drag them out, you can see it creates a label at the top and it does group these together. And of course, you can customize this and make them any color or whatever that you want, and you can customize the script. So hey, if you're interested, stay tuned and we'll get started. We are going to start in Graphics Designer, and I've just created a blank page to add this VBA script. And the first thing that we're going to do is open the Visual Basic for Applications editor. And as it turns out, the PDLs, which are your graphic screens in WinCC, are VBA forms. And so we have a lot of the benefits that come with that. We can know when HMI objects are added to the screen, when they're moved, when they're removed from the screen, and things like that. And then we can write VBA code to react to those events. You'll notice that we have three different templates. We have a template for the individual document that you're on. So code that I write here will only work on this particular page. And then we have a project template document. This means that the VBA will be available to any graphics designer document in this particular project. And finally, we have the global template document, which would be applicable to any WinCC project on this computer. And so if you're making some design tools in VBA and you want to use them in different projects, then you would want to put your code here. For now, I'm just going to put it on this document. So I'm just going to click to open the document. Notice here, it's got just general functions. There's nothing on this page. But if I go to document, this is where you see all the different actions and events that happen to this HMI screen. And so we've got things like HMI object added, HMI object moved, HMI object property changed. And so we can use all these events and put code in them to do what we want. So for this particular example, we want to detect when an HMI object has been added to the screen. We want to check if it's an IO field. And if it is, we want to see what tag is associated with the output value property of that IO field. And then we want to create a static text object that is aligned with the IO field. And so what we'll do is we will go to the HMI object added and click this, and it's going to add in the event handler. And so I will just write some comments here and say event triggered when HMI object is added to the screen. I'll just put a message box. This just displays a message box, and I'll just say object added, and then I will do this object, which is the object you see this is actually passed in. So I'll just do this object dot object name. And I will also print out the type of object. So IO field, bar graph, what have we. So I'll save this. So we'll test this out. I'll add a static text. So it caught that. It added an object named static text one, and it's an HMI static text. So we'll do an IO field, and we have to pick a tag so it's not actually added yet. When I hit OK, it's added, and it says it's an object name IO field 1 and its type HMI IO field. So we can use this HMI object added event to detect whether or not there is an IO field, and if there is, then we need to go do our other stuff, see if there is a tag associated with it and things like that. So if you've ever taken a class with me, I do teach WinCC classes and I do some online stuff, but I like to put my comments first and then we can go in and fill the code out. So here we've got step one, detect if added object was an IO field. And then after that, Step two is if the IO field has an associated tag. And then three, we create and configure a static text object. And then that's it. So obviously this last one is going to take some lines of code. Here we will just say if, and I'll just copy this, if this object type equals HMIObjectAdded, and then we'll put our endif down here. And so here we're just going to put our steps in here. And then the next thing we want to know is, does it have a tag? Well, basically the way that we do that, and a lot of this is in the help for WinCC VBA, but we'll just do this object and then we'll look at the properties collection, and then we can just specify, hey, go look at this particular property. Well, for IO fields, when we add a tag to an IO field, it always goes to the output value property. So we're going to look at the output value, the dynamic state type. So it's been made dynamic. Is it a tag? Is it a script? Is it a VBA, C script? Is it an animation? So we'll just do dynamic state type equals. And there's a constant in the help file that tells you an enumeration of the different state types that exist. And HMI dynamic state type variable direct means this is a tag associated directly with a property. Variable indirect would be an indirect. And then there's also scripts and stuff like that. That information is in the help file under the VBA section, and it shows you all of this stuff. So here, I want to make sure that this object properties is HMI variable state type, and then I'll do another then, and then we will put our endif here, okay? And then, of course, this comment now is going to be moved inside here. And I like to indent my stuff, so I'm just going to indent everything in there. Here, we're just going to add our message box just to make sure that we are detecting only IO fields. So I'll just put it inside of this if statement and just say IO field added. I'll make sure to spell it right though. So we're just going to save this and do a quick gut check, make sure everything's okay. So I'll go back. I'm just going to get rid of these objects. So if I add a different type of object, it should not trigger now because they're not of that type. But if I put an IO field here, and I'll just grab a tag. All right, so it did only detect the IO field. So far that code is looking good. Okay, so going back to the VBA code, what I'm going to do is I am going to write a subroutine to handle creating the label, and I'm just going to call it create label. And we're just going to add an argument. Oops. Let's call it reference object as, and it's going to be type IHMI object. So this is your type of object that we're passing in. We have to put function here, and then it'll add our end function. So here we're going to do our comments again. And then first one is assume there is a tag assigned. And so we need to grab that name. So I'll just create a variable called tag name. And then we'll just say tag name equals. That is going to be our reference object, and then our properties. So this is the collection of properties. And we, again, are looking at output value. And then we're looking at the dynamics on that. And we're looking for the var name. And next, we need to actually create a label. So let's just say create a static text label. So we will create a variable and just call it object label as, and this is going to be HMI static text. And then we're going to use the set command, and we're going to set our object label equal to, and just like VBA and other applications, we have an active document and we want to look at the collection of HMI objects and we want to add an HMI object. So we've got it there and we're going to give it a name. So I'm just going to call this text IO label, and then I'll do an underscore and I'm going to do the tag name. I do this to kind of make sure this is kind of unique. You can't add an object that's the same name as another object. So that's going to be the name of the HMI object, and then we need to tell it what type of object it is, and that's just going to be HMI static text. And again, all this is defined in the object model for VBA, and you can find that in the help file. So we'll just close that parenthesis out. And we need to align the label with the IO field. I always spell that wrong. And so what we want to do is our object label, the left alignment, which is your X alignment, should basically be the same as our reference object dot left. Now for our Y alignment, which is called top, we're just going to grab this name here and I'll add top, but that's going to put it right over the top of the IO field. And your Y axis, the numbers grow larger as you go down the page. So we want it to be above, so it's going to be a smaller coordinate. So we'll just say, okay, minus the reference object dot height. So it'll move it up by the height of the object. And then we also want to subtract kind of a fudge factor. We don't want it right on top of it, or at least I don't. So I'm just going to do 10 pixels. So this is going to place the object 10 pixels above the IO field. And we also want to do our object label dot width is going to be the same thing as our reference object dot width. And we want our object label dot height to be the same as our reference object height. So that'll make it basically the same width, same height. It'll place it kind of nicely. As you see here, I've gone ahead and put in our housekeeping, which is we're setting this label to nothing so that we're not leaking memory. So let's just check and see where we're at with this. I'm going to hit save. I'll go back to our screen. I'll grab an IO field. Actually, I'm just going to pull this tag out. And it did place a label directly above this. So obviously, I need to set the text property for the tag name. And I could also get the alignment. My IO field is aligned center in both the X and Y direction. So we'll just pop back over to VBA. And we will say object label. And then we'll do align left equals. Now, notice that it doesn't show some of the properties here on our reference object. That's because this is passed in and it doesn't really know what it is, so it can't show the correct IntelliSense. It can just show the generic ones. But since we created the label, then it knows exactly what object it is and it knows what to fill in. So that's why that's like that. So I'm just going to copy this, and our alignment top is going to be the same as our IO fields alignment top. And then we need to set the text. We'll just say text is equal to tag name. And we'll save that and we'll go back and check this out. So here's an IO field. I'm not going to do the same tag. I'll do this mixed tank level. So here you can see that I made a mistake and the debugger took me directly to it. That's what I get for kind of copying that. So I'll just make a quick fix for that. The yellow shows you where that is. And I totally did that on purpose so I could show you how the debugger looks. And I'm sure that you believe me. So we're going to test this out. I'm just going to get rid of these guys. I am just going to drag this guy out there. And boom, it made us a nice label and put it 10 pixels directly above. Now you can obviously vary that and make it look exactly how you want. So the last thing is we're going to group these together so that they're not independent. So we will go back to our VBA code. So I'll just click the VBA button here. And what we want to do here, I'll add a comment. Group the two objects. So I will create a variable called my group as HMI group. And then what we want to do is we want to select both of the objects. So my reference object, which was passed in, it has a selected property. And if it's true, that means it is selected on the screen. So I'll just set that to true. And then also my object label selected equals true. So they're both now selected. And then what I want to do is set my group equals, and we'll look at the active document dot selection. So that's a list of everything that is selected. And then we will just do create group. You see it there in the list. All right, that will create the group. And then we can also give it a name. So let's add a comment here. Say group the objects. And we've got to give the group a name. So we'll just say my group dot object name. So our object name, so we're just going to make it something like group, and we'll add the tag name. And let's test this final version. So I'll hit save here, and I'll go back. So I'll try my test sent. There's my test long. These are all tags that I've created. And you can see that they are grouped. And if we go look, there's our group test float. And you can see that it's got the IO fields and everything. Now, a couple of tips about this. You're going to need to update this script if there's a possibility that you're going to be adding something where there's an object already named that. So you probably want to put in some error handling to make sure that the object name doesn't already exist before you use it. Another thing is, if you run into debug issues with VBA and then the script just seems to stop triggering, just close VBA in Graphics Designer and reopen it. Okay, so that's all I've got for you today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, I'd really appreciate you subscribing. Give me a like, shout out comments, and if you have suggestions for future videos, please drop me a line. Thanks.